A very good morning, students. Welcome back to our online class. Today, which class it is? English grammar class. Okay. Last class, what we have learned about grammar? What we have learned about nouns? Right? We have learned about material noun and abstract noun. Right? We have learned about material noun and abstract noun. We have learned the material noun is what? The name given for a noun from which the items are made, right? From which the items are made, for that material we are giving a name, that is called as material name, material noun. Okay. And what is abstract noun? Abstract noun is the noun which we can feel or think, but we cannot see or touch, right? We have done the exercises for that also, you all know now. Now, and after that, what we learned? The countable and uncountable nouns. The countable means what? The nouns which we can count. The things which we can count is called as countable nouns. The nouns which we cannot count is called as uncountable nouns. We have learned, right? And what we use in case of countable and uncountable? Countable, we use how many in the question, right? You all know, we have done that also. For countable, in the question, we use how many. For uncountable, we use how much. Till that, we have learned. And now, what we are going to learn in this class? It is about plurals. You all know plurals. See, most singular nouns form the plural by adding s. There are different kinds of plurals. We can write plurals in different kinds. In some plurals, we can add only s. In some plurals, we should add es. And in some others, we should add ies or ves, like that. See, example, key, toy. Here what we add? Only s, k-e-y-s, t-o-y, yes. Yes, no, only this s we'll add to make it in a plural form. But in some cases, see here, bus, box. Here, how we will write the plural form? It is B-U-S-E-S. We'll add buses, right? Box, boxes. We'll add ES. See here, we'll add ES. Here, we are adding only S. Here, in this case, we are adding ES. And next, see, for this, life. Life. What we'll do? Here we'll remove F-E. L-I-V-E-S. We'll remove this F-E and we'll write V-E-S. Okay? And half. In this case also, see, half. It is F here. We'll remove this F. H-A-L. We'll remove this F and we'll write V-E-L. Okay, this is a different kind. So we'll write the words in a plural form. Okay, now we'll solve the exercise. The another one they have given. See, baby. Yeah, here we'll add I-E-S. The words or nouns which ends with Y. We'll remove this Y. And we'll write B-A-B-I-E-S. C-I-T, we'll remove Y and write I-E-S. Right? You all know this. And next to C. Child. Here how we'll write? Child, right? We'll add S or E-S, child is. Or what we'll write? We'll write child is one child. Children means more children, right? The child. Children. This is the plural form. Child, children. See here. Tooth. Teeth. More than one tooth we call as teeth. Foot. Feet. Right? Likewise, this is the different kinds of plural forms. We'll write the words in a plural form. Understood? Now, we'll solve the exercise. I didn't told page number, right? It was page number 27. Now we are doing the exercise in page number 28. Okay. Now the exercise part, it is page number 28 exercise. Now it is fifth name. Change these nouns to plural forms. They have given the nouns. We have to change that into plural forms. Okay. Baby, babies. Elephant, elephants. Fox, foxes. Bench, benches. Door, doors. Thief, thieves. City, cities. Tooth, teeth. Sheep, sheeps. Chair, chairs. Tomato, tomatoes. Deer, deers. Monkey, monkeys. Key, keys. Next is last one, man, men. Okay, see here, we have changed all the nouns in different kinds of plurals. Here we have removed y in baby. We have removed y and we are adding ies, babies, right? Here only s we have added. Here fox, es we have added. Here bench, benches, es is added. Door, doors, only s. Thief, here if will be there, F. We have removed F and we have added D-E-S, thieves. City, we are removing Y and we are writing cities, I-E-S. Likewise, the tooth, teeth. Sheep, sheeps. Chair, chairs. Tomato, tomatoes. Deer, deers. Monkey, monkeys. Key, keys. Man, men. Plural form of man and women is men, women. Okay, this is the plurals. Now see, underline the correct word. We have to underline the correct word here. There are many in the bracket. They have given two words. One is plural form, one is singular form. We should see which one is the correct for that sentence. There are many dash in this notebook. We can't say there are many page. It is many pages. I'll write the correct answer here. It is 6th May. Only the answer I'll write there. In your book, in the answer, you have to underline which is the correct answer. See the board and underline that answer, the word. Okay, which is the correct answer for that sentence? Underline that. Okay, see, there are many pages. This is the correct one. Either you can underline or else tick mark. Understood? The old man's tooth have fallen off. Tooth. One tooth. He wears a watch. Cut the apple into half. The glass is full. There are 3 mice in the hole. Mice. Plural of mouse is mice. I read a story about ghosts. Story. Eighth one, there are few buses on the road today. Few buses. Some snakes are poisonous snakes. Trees shed all their leaves. The women are in the shop. Women. Three children sit on a bench. Okay. So this is the correct form of the words which we have used, which we have to use in that sentence. See, once again, I read. There are many pages in this notebook. The old man's tooth have fallen off. He wears a watch. Cut the apple into two halves. Sorry, it is two halves, right? Two. More than one, it is halves. We should write halves, okay? Cut the apple into two halves. The glass is full. There are three mice in the hole. I read a story about ghosts. There are few buses on the road today. Some snakes are poisonous. Trees shed all their leaves in autumn. The women are in the shop. Three children sit on a bench. Okay? And now, next main, change the nouns in the sentences to singular or plural form. Here, we have to change the sentences in singular as well as plural. Okay? Now, I'll wrap this. The seventh main. First one. There is a boat on the river. There is a boat. They have told we have to change. There are boats on the river. There are boats on the river. Second one, dash, they have given and they have given leaves are green. In the before dash, what we have to write? Leaf is green. Third one, a baby is small. The babies are small. The babies are small. See here, they have given. See here, first one. For this answer, we have to write here. Next to that only answer. For second one, they have given blank and they have written answer. We have to write there in a singular form. Third one, answer here. Okay. The same way. In the same row, you have to write the answers. Fourth one. This story is interesting. These stories are interesting. We have to write this story is interesting. This story is interesting. Light the candle. Light the candles, candles, plural. Look at this watch. Look at this watch. The mango is ripe. The mangoes are ripe. Eighth one, I'll write here. There are many fish in the pond. There is a fish in the pond. There is a fish in the pond. Ninth one. There is a deer in the zoo. There are deers in the zoo. There are deers in the zoo. Rose is beautiful. Rose is beautiful. They have given roses are beautiful. Okay, this is how we'll change the sentences into singular or plural where it is necessary. Now, next it is singular countable nouns refer to one person, one place, animal or thing. Singular countable nouns, it refers to only one person. Plural countable nouns, it refers to more than one person, place, animal or thing. Okay, here they have given one passage. Here we have to pick out the countable and uncountable nouns in the passage. See, first we'll read the passage. It was a beautiful morning. The air was fresh and clean. Cherry decided to go for a walk on the beach. As he was walking on the sand, he saw some pebbles and shells. He picked up a few and put them into his pocket. He saw some fishermen with their nets. They were getting ready for the day's work. They got into their boats and sailed away. Cherry sat on the shore. The waves touched his feet. The water was cool. Okay. Here we have to pick out the countable and uncountable nouns. See here, which are the countable and uncountable in this? We'll write. They have given two columns. Countable nouns we have to write in this, uncountable nouns we have to write in this. Okay, now I'll rub the board. See now, here I'll write, okay? I'll write here countable nouns. C-N means countable nouns. U-C-N means uncountable nouns. Okay, we'll write. See, it was a beautiful morning. The air was fresh and clean. Air. Air here is uncountable. Was fresh and clean. Cherry. Cherry is a countable noun. Decided to go for a walk on the beach. Beach, it is countable. As he was walking on the sand. Sand is uncountable. He saw some pebbles. Pebbles and shells. Plurals, uncountable. He picked up a few and put them into his pocket. Pocket is only one, it is countable and singular. He saw some fishermen. Fishermen, men. It is plural. With their nets, N-E-T-S, nets, plural. They were getting ready for the day's work. They got into their boats, plural, and sailed away. Cherry sat on the shore. The waves touched his feet. Waves. Waves is uncountable. And feet. Feet is a plural. The water was cool. Water, again, it is uncountable. Okay. See now, once again, I'll read only the answers. Countable nouns, only four. Cherry, beach, pocket, shore. Okay. Uncountable nouns, air, sand, pebbles, shells, fishermen, nets, boats, waves, feet, water. Okay, these are the countable and uncountable nouns in this passage. Complete that. Quick. Write fast. Okay, completed. Shall I wrap this now? Complete it then and there itself, students. Don't keep it incomplete. Again, it will be extra work. Now only I am giving time to write. No, complete it now itself. Now, in this nouns, next topic is possessive forms. Okay, possessive means what? When we want to show ownership or possession, we use the possessive form of a noun. When we want to show ownership or possession, when it is, when we feel it is mine, when we feel it is like ours, we use a possessive form when we want to show ownership or possession, when we feel it is ours. If you have any pen, you will tell it is mine, right? You will tell it is yours. You only take, you will tell if it is yours, you will not give to anyone. You will tell it is mine. If any book, you will tell it is mine. Yes, no? And even which you wear the clothes also. Right? You will tell it is mine. Don't touch. You will not give for your sisters or brothers also. You will tell it is mine. That is the possessiveness. Okay? The possessive form of a noun. It is an apostrophe which is raised comma placed above the line of writing. For that apostrophe, what we will tell? Apostrophe means when we write a letter, Rams means what? If it is Rams, if any one pen is Rams means, we'll write apostrophe, right? Yes, no? Apostrophe. This form will show the possessiveness, possessive form of noun will show in this form. Okay? Now, we'll do the, see, they have given some examples. For singular nouns, we add an apostrophe S after the noun. For singular nouns, we add apostrophe S after the noun. Uday's computer. Suma's brother. The cat's tail. Okay. For plural nouns that end in S, we add an apostrophe after the S. The plural which ends with S, we add apostrophe after that S. For plural nouns that do not end in s, we add an apostrophe and s. See, for singular nouns, if a person, any person, Uday, see here, Uday, they have given how they have written. After his name, they have written apostrophe s. Yes, no? And in the, this is singular noun. In the plural noun, how they'll write? Boys, hostel, ladies. In this way, they'll write apostrophe after the S. Okay? And plurals which do not end in S. The plurals, this is the plural form. It won't end with S. So what they'll write again, we'll write apostrophe S like this. Okay? This is the apostrophe we'll use in different types. For things or places, we do not usually use an apostrophe and S. We normally use of before things or places. See here, the wheels of the car, the door of the house, the door is that house is only, right? That house door it is. So that is the, we are not using apostrophe S. Instead of apostrophe S, we are telling, we are using of. Okay. See, now we'll do some exercises. Write the following by using the possessive form of the nouns as shown. She is the English teacher of Vinay. Here, they have changed that form into in a different way. She is Vinay's English teacher. Okay. Now we have to write that form. See, it is the birthday of Tanu next month. How we will write? See, first one, what they have given? She is English teacher of Vinay. What was the answer? She is Vinay's English teacher. In the same way, what we'll write? It is the birthday of Tanu next month. Means what we'll write? It is Tanu's birthday next month. Okay. It is Tanu apostrophe S. It is Tanu's birthday next month. It is Tanu's birthday next month. The bag of Mithila is in classroom. What we'll write? Mithila's bag is in the classroom. Mithila is a noun. So we are adding S apostrophe S after the noun. Mithila's bag is in the classroom. Mithila's bag is in the classroom. Now next one. I have lost the book of my friend. I have lost my friend's book. I have lost my friend apostrophe S book. I have lost my friend's book. This is the car of my uncle. This car is my uncle's. This car is my uncle's. The chicks of the hen are behind the mother hen. The chicks are behind the mother hen. The chicks are behind the mother Hen. Okay, this is how we'll change. See, once again, I'll read. It is Tanu's birthday next month. Mithila's bag is in the classroom. I have lost my friend's book. This car is my uncle's. The chicks are behind the mother hen. Okay. Now, next, here are some plural nouns. Write them using possessive forms. I'll rub this. Copy down fast. If you are writing very slowly, 2 minutes take time. Pause it. Write fast and get ready for the next main. Okay. So now, next, second main. Here are some plurals. Write them in possessive forms. The plurals, what we have to write in a possessive form. The permission of my parents. Parents, how we'll write? P-A-R-E-N-T-S, apostrophe after S. The room of the children. Children's. Children's, apostrophe S. The bicycles of the boys. Boys, apostrophe after S. The books of the students. Students, apostrophe after S. The room of girls. Girls, apostrophe after S. A shop for ladies. Ladies, after S, apostrophe. Okay. And next, correct the following as shown. The book's pages are torn. How we'll write? The pages of the book are torn. The pages of book are torn. The first one they have done. So from the second one, we have to. She cleaned the fan's blades. The blades of fan are cleaned by her. The blades of fan are cleaned by her. The blades of fan are cleaned by her. The table's legs are broken. The legs of table are broken. The lamp's bulb needs to be changed. The bulb of lamp needs to be changed. The bulb of lamp needs to be changed. She closed the car's door. The door of car was closed by her. The door of car was closed by her. Okay. Now, next main is homework. Fourth main. It is page number 32. Fourth main is homework. Understood? And again, with this complete English cursive writing, another 5 pages. First I gave 1 to 5, 5 pages you have to write. I told no. And now it is again the second homework of cursive writing. You have to complete till page number 10. Understood? Page number 10, it should be completed cursive writing and get it for the correction. And now see, once I'll tell how you have to do this fourth main. Correct the words in bold. They have given some words in bold letters. You have to correct it. How you will do? In the last main, we have done, see, in the second main, parents, children, the same way, we have to correct it. How? My father name is Prakash Raj. Father, after father, you have to write father's apostrophe S. Apostrophe S, father's name. You all know how you will write S, no? School name, school's name, apostrophe S. Friend name, friend's name, apostrophe S. Renu's house, apostrophe S. Book name, book's name, apostrophe S. Here all you use only apostrophe S. After apostrophe, you will write S. Father's, school's, friends, Renu's, books. Okay? This is a, see, you have to write full bold words. What the again? Father name, father's name. School name, school's name. Friend name, friend's name. Renu house, Renu's house. Book name, book's name. Like this, you have to write. Okay? This is a homework, a fourth main. It is page number 32, grammar, possessive nouns. It is a homework. And with this, you have to write cursive writing till page number 10. I hope you all have understood about the nouns, collective nouns, material noun, common noun, proper noun, abstract noun. And next was the plurals, countable, uncountable, and possessive noun. Right? You all have understood? No doubt in this. Once again, go through the exercises what you have done. Okay? And practice well, students. Complete the homework. Thank you.